If you guys have ever played my map, you're probably wondering how I got the bots to move, so today, I thought I'd show you guys exactly how to do that. Alright, so before we get started, let's actually go into the settings because there's some you might want to have on when you do this. So go to the game settings and make sure that the time limit is set to none here so you don't run out of time. And make sure you have 100% shields, infinite ammo on. Scroll down a little bit. Make sure building can destroy environment is set to no, and environment damage is set to player build only. This will make it so when you're shooting, you won't destroy anything in the map. And then some other optional things is like eliminated players items to keep so that you don't drop your weapons in case you die to the bot. And you can also set your respawn time to 1 second, and then glider redeploy off. Those are the usual settings I usually do as soon as I start up a map. Oh, and also while you're testing the map, it's good to have your spawn location to current location. That way when you start the game, you don't spawn in the sky. But make sure once you're finished with everything, you set this back to spawn pads so everything's working just fine. So now let's get into what you actually need. So we're going to start off with the sentries first. So obviously you're going to have to get some sentries here. And then you're also going to need a trick tile and some speed boosters. Now sentries do not get affected by bouncers, but zombies do. So just keep that in mind. But anyways, just to show you how quick and easy this is to set up, I'm going to do it really quickly and then I'll show you guys how to do it. So just like that, it literally took me 10 seconds to set this up. But anyways, let's get on to the actual tutorial. Okay, so let's get started. So once you have all the devices you need, basically, to set up the bot anywhere you want, you just want to go above where you want to drop the bot. So for example, if you wanted to drop a bot on top of a pyramid, you put a pyramid here and a floor up there. That's where the sentry is going to be. Or if you wanted a sentry to be on top of a stair, you would put a stair under the sentry spawn and so on. But basically, all you want to do is place the sentry up here. The weapon type, health, and shield is all completely up to you. All of these settings are completely personal preference. But you do want to have the respawn timer on, probably like 2 seconds. And if you don't want the bot to shoot at you, make sure the range is at the smallest range possible. Then once you got the bot set up, get your trick tile out and go under the floor where you placed the bot and place the trick tile under that. And then all you really want to do is make sure that this activates on game start. And make sure trigger on player contact is to no. And then activation delay doesn't really matter, but I like to set this to 1 second. These are the usual settings I run. And just like that, you have a sentry that's going to fall down. But now we have to set the speed boosters. And this is personal preference. You can create any path you want from here. So for example, if you wanted the bot just to go straight in a square like this, just like that. Now you may notice that once you set this up, that the bot will be moving extremely fast. And this is pretty much impossible to track unless you're on controller. Usually I set my speed boosters to low because it'll be too fast to track. The only time I have it on medium or high is when I'm launching the bot up into the air. But when I'm just doing like horizontal tracking like this, I make sure to keep all of them on low. And just like that, you got a nice little tracking scenario. Now obviously you would want to add more health because this is way too easy. Now if you want to make these speed pads invisible like I usually do in my maps, all you gotta do is go into the galleries and go to the cubes wherever they are. So right here, so let's grab the cube gallery large. And you can choose any of them, but I usually like to choose this glossy black tile here. It looks nice. So let's make sure we resize this to the size of the square. And then from here, make sure your grid snap is on like 4. And then from here, just make sure that the speed pads are working. So we can see that they are working here and you cannot see the speed pads at all, which is pretty nice. So that people can't see the path and it makes it more unpredictable when they're trying to track. Now if you set this too high, for example like this, it's obviously not going to work. So make sure you set it just right so it's right above the speed pads, not too high, not too low, just perfect so they can work and hide the speed pads. Now let's say you don't really like the look of this wall, there's a way to make a floating platform without using this hover platform because this hover platform is kind of ugly in my opinion. There's a much cleaner way to do it. So in the galleries, all you want to do is go to the filters on the left side, filter by terrain. And I usually like using the winter one, and then the top, the very top left one is the floor you want. And then from here, you can place this right about here. Let's just delete this wall real quick. Then we're going to have to set this up again. So right here, you can see, you can actually place floors on top of this. So that's how I create floating platforms. Now, obviously, you can resize that so it's not visible and glitching out like that, but just for the purpose of this video, we're going to leave it like that. And then let me just set up the bot real quick again. Perfect. And you're good to go. And to hide this extra grass right in the middle, we can just place a few floors there and that grass should disappear. So there you go, you got a pretty nice tracking section. Now to make this even better still, we can make it randomized. Now the way I make randomized tracking is pretty simple. So we're just gonna delete or move this real quick. Okay, so you're just gonna wanna build a 9x9 square. Now I placed these cones here because we're not gonna be building anything in these areas. So basically when making randomized tracking, you do not want any of the speed boosters pointing outside or else the bot will go out here and then he will be knocked off the tracking area. So for example, we're going to start here and then maybe we want to go kind of in here this way. So you can see I really have no pattern here going on. I'm just going placing these randomly, making sure none of them are pointing out there. So there we go. We now have the randomized path. Now for the gaps right here, all you want to do is make sure you add a speed booster in any direction. Doesn't matter as long as it's not facing the outside, like I said, or the inside. Make sure they're not pointing inwards into here also. So this one right here kind of messed up there. And from here you can tell that this looks pretty ugly and you can tell which direction the bot is going to go by looking at the floor. So we are going to have to cover this up just like we did with the old one. Alright, so make sure you guys just resize these properly and make sure you put them all around. Okay, so just like that, we've covered it all up just like that. And now you can't see the path, which makes it even better. And to get to the middle, you could place some teleporters if you wanted to, just like that. Pretty easy. But just for the video, we're just going to start right here. Now I actually forgot to put the speed boosters on low, so before you place these big tiles in the way, make sure you do that first, that way it's not confusing. But I'm gonna just do that real quick and skip ahead. Alright, so as you can see, the bot is now moving randomly. We can't really see which path he's gonna go because we blocked off the speed pads, which is perfect because when you're training your aim, you really want the movement to be unpredictable. That's where you're gonna get the best practice. And then you can add even more bots to make this even better. Maybe one in each corner like I usually do. But anyways, let's move on to the zombies. Okay, now for the zombies, it's actually way easier to set up. All you're gonna need is a creature placer or a zombie spawner. Now which one you use depends on what you want to do. So for example, if you want to place a zombie in a precise location, like let's say we want the zombie to spawn exactly right there where I placed it, we would use a creature placer. And then the zombie spawner, I'll just go through the settings real quick that I use. Oh, and also forgot to mention, you probably also want a creature manager. And just for the video, let's go to keep it on fiend. Make sure the health, if you're going to do tracking, make sure it's really high. And for flick shots, make sure it's low. But we're just going to go for, let's say, 200 health for now. Score doesn't really matter right now. Let's make it so it doesn't damage the player and no damage to the environment. Let's make sure he moves very slow so he doesn't escape. That's pretty much it for the creature manager. Now we can go here to the creature spawner. Make sure it's set to fiend. Usually I like to set that to eye spawner. It just looks nicer, even though you're not going to see it in game. Make sure number of creatures is set to 1. Wave timer is fine at 3. Activation range. You just want to make sure wherever you're standing that this is going to activate. So just set that to wherever you need it to be. Despawn range. You can set this really high so it doesn't despawn on you. Make sure it's an invincible spawner. Off, 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 off. And then max spawn distance doesn't really matter. Depends on what distance you want them to spawn in. So let's say if we want to set up a randomized spawn, all we're going to want to do is do that. And make sure preferred spawn location is set to random. And it'll spawn randomly in any one of these tiles. Now in this scenario, it doesn't really matter because there's a certain path that's going to follow either way. But for certain scenarios, that can be pretty useful. Okay, so we're going to be hopping into Train Island V5 just to give you some inspiration on how to use zombies and how to move them around and stuff. So let's start off with rain. So with rain, I made it so as soon as you start here, it'll start a loop over here. Right there. And then these right here are the zombie spawners. So let's say this is zombie 1, zombie 2, and so on. Every time this loops right here, this activates the randomizer. And it activates one of these zombies completely randomly to be launched in one of these directions. Now this is kind of for a more advanced video, but just to show you guys that you can really be creative with this and do anything you want. But like I said, if you guys want a video on this, let me know and I'll make a more advanced version. Anyways, for the pop-up, it is extremely complicated looking, but once you get the hang of it, it's quite simple. Basically, there is 3 spawners on each of these corners, and each of these spawners are just different health. So for example, when you click 10 HP, it only activates the 10 HP ones, and so on. And then you can see the range right here. So I have it set to like 2 tile range, so it spawns randomly in one of these squares. And I made these on top of the walls so they don't get stuck on top of the walls. If I deleted this, they could easily just camp on top of the walls, but as you can see right there, it makes it so they slide off when I put those there. And then to create bouncer zombies, it's really simple. Honestly, all you want to do is create like a 7x7 square with a bunch of bouncers. Then you can copy these settings if you'd like. But anyways, hopefully you guys learned something from this video and it gave you inspiration towards the end there on how to use zombies and sentries for aim practice. You can just simply load into one of my maps and see all the scenarios I have to give you some inspiration. But anyways, if you guys enjoyed and found this helpful, please drop a like and let me know if you guys run into any issues. I'll answer them for you, and I'll see you in the next one.